But first, a brazen daylight murder has sparked fears of a new underworld war in Melbourne. The shooting death of the infamous Chaouk family figurehead in the yard of his Brooklyn home has raised police concerns of a blood-for-blood payback.
The attack was swift and sudden, a shooting that left the patriarch of a notorious family dead.
I believe a gunman has got out of the vehicle and fired shots at a male in the backyard of the house. And the gunman has got back into the vehicle and has left the scene.
Just as swift was the police response. Special Operations Group officers sweeping into the Chaouk compound amid fears of revenge attacks. With the gunman still on the loose, surrounding streets were locked down. Heavily armed officers warning onlookers away.
We're going to need you to move. We need you to head down that way a little bit. It's not safe here. Not at all.
Police tried to console distraught family members and friends, but instead became targets of anger outside the cordoned off house. Many of the grieving forced to watch on from a distance as the horror of the morning became more real. Relatives had tried to resuscitate 65-year-old Macchour Chaouk. He'd been shot several times in the upper body in what police say was a targeted attack.
This appears to not to be a random drive-by shooting, so at this stage we don't have concerns for general members of the public.
Ambulance crews told to wait until the property was declared safe by police. By then it was too late to save him. The victim's wife and three young grandchildren, inside during the shooting, later taken from the home. The shooting has raised fears of a new underworld war. Police admit they suspect members of a rival Lebanese family and that their biggest concern now is reprisal attacks.
It is obviously a concern and we'll look at putting some processes in place to prevent that from happening.
Anger directed at the media pack, with one supporter calling out to journalists, "It's all your fault you brought this on us." An elderly witness, too frightened to speak on camera, says he heard loud arguing this morning, followed by the sound of sirens as police and ambulance crews arrived. Another witness says several shots rang out just before 11 a.m. Police are scouring CCTV vision for clues to the shooter. Kate McGrath, 10 News.